Okay, let's proceed to
another, you know, next, you know, topic. So next one is the status of ML Linux, you know, Linux. So please proceed.
Yes, so I apologize in advance. I've got another meeting coming up, so I'm going to do this a little bit quick. So I apologize for that. But a lot of you have seen kind of this style of presentation before, but I'll do this fairly quick. So let's get right into it. I'm going to talk about kernel versions, technology areas, a little bit about the CE workgroup project, some other stuff, and then point you to some resources. So let's start with kernel versions. So the last main stable version, or last .o version released, was 5th of October, just this month. And notice that the number of days has been shortening. It's now, we had one release that was only 57 days, less than 2 months, which was pretty interesting. But we're on 3.18 RC1 now. In 3.16, we saw a couple of interesting things: PowerAware scheduling, some more changes there, decode stack trace, which is a debugging tool, F2FS large volume support. There's not a whole lot of embedded stuff going on, mostly because a lot of the embedded really overlapped with enterprise and server features these days. Next. In 3.17, we saw lots of ARM hardware support, both new boards, brand new boards like these listed, and then a bunch of other ARM boards with existing support also saw improvements. And then something having to do with testing, there was a rework of config bisect mode in K-test. That's it for, in terms of things to watch, the Android patches and staging. So that is something interesting I'll talk about a little bit later. Technology areas. So let's go through these, and these are actually, I believe, in alphabetical order. So in boot up time, there's been some recently some discussion about the deferred init calls patch. This has been a patch that's been poking around the industry for, oh gosh, probably at least 8 years, maybe 9 years. It was resurrected recently for a mainline attempt, and the discussion is ongoing. You can go look at that. There were some good presentations at ELC Europe, 12 Lessons Learned in Boot Time Reduction and Fast Boot Profiling Analysis Method and Tools by different authors. These guys are both experts at this type of stuff, so some good material that's available. Okay, next slide. Graphics. I don't have very much to report here. The only thing I have is I've heard some vague reports about continuing improvements to open source drivers for popular GPUs, but I don't know of any products that are shipping yet with those open source drivers. Everybody is still using proprietary drivers. In file systems, this hasn't really been really embedded. I think we're doing okay on embedded file systems. Most systems, because they're using EMMC, have now switched over to EXT4 or something. But I did talk to Ted Cho, who's the XT4 maintainer, and he says there's lots of high-end magnetic media is switching over to shingled magnetic recording, SMR. And this is really interesting because it has similarities to flash storage with regions that are handled similar to erase blocks. It's just like writing to an SSD in terms of how you have to handle some issues with having a translation layer in that. But instead, you have high seek latencies compared to SSDs. So some interesting work there. Not sure how that's going to reconcile with the flash-based media as opposed to the spinning magnetic media. But that's the latest news there. In terms of power management, at ELC, there was a lot of focus on power measurement devices. Not a bunch of new technology. At Plumbers, there was quite a bit of discussion about energy management and power management. And the big thing there was developers are really interested in getting performance hinting from applications. Particularly for big.little, they want to pin some items to the little processor And I heard of one case where an application was refactored from a single process into multiple processes that could then be run on the little processor in a asymmetric system. These are asymmetric systems are quite popular now in order to save power and use big dot little. Next slide. So the big thing here is energy aware scheduling, and big dot little is definitely part of that, where you've got different hardware. But there's also one of the things with energy aware is being able to predict the wake up by automatically tracking the I/O latency. And if you know when the next wake up is with high certainty, you can do a much better choice of picking the idle state to go to. Also, there's a lot of tools that are being written to measure and analyze energy efficiency. No really great breakthroughs. This is kind of slowly evolving. And another area is CPU Freak being integrated into the scheduler. So that's being done. This is all part of energy aware scheduling. Frank Rowan, who's following this stuff kind of closer than I am, says this is still a very long-term effort, more than 5 years to get all this stuff that's been kind of being talked about into the kernel. Let's see. System size. So there's a renewed kernel size reduction project. Leader of this is Josh Triplett. So for many years we did the Linux Tiny project. The new name is kernel tinification. That's Josh's term. And he led a lot of good discussion at the Kernel Summit, and that's covered in that LWN.net article listed there. And he also gave a talk at ELC Europe, and we had a BOF there as well. So there's a lot of interest in working on the kernel size. And that renewed emphasis is due to primarily interest in the Internet of Things. In particular, there are new higher-end 32-bit microcontrollers coming on the market with 512 to 10, so 1 meg of static RAM. Some people are interested in running Linux on that without any dynamic RAM. In terms of tool chains, the big news here seems to be LLVMs getting used more and more. Including Linux kernel, they're very, very close to being able to compile mainline with LLVM. They've also been building Android with Clang, which is essentially another name for LLVM. Next slide. So they have built Nexus 7 and 10 are booting using software that's been compiled with LLVM, and Tan can run many apps. Nexus 4 and 5 are still problematic, but a lot of the patches to support that have been submitted and have been accepted upstream. 74 accepted, 34 waiting. So GCC performance, that is performance of compilation, not of the resulting code. The resulting code is almost is very, very close. But the performance of compilation, GCC is still a faster compiler than LLVM. But Clang or LLVM is finding real bugs because it's providing a whole alternate compiler toolchain suite. So next slide. In terms of testing, the big news for kernel testing was at the Kernel Summit, there's a new thing, and this is, I think this was new in 3.16, but it's been fleshed out, and in 3.17 and 3.18, I think you'll start to see it. K-self test. So you can now, from inside the kernel, build directory or the source repository, you can do a make kself test. It currently supports host mode. It's being worked on for cross build. And so there's an article on that if you want to read more about that. That's coming up to a kernel new year. Okay, next slide. CD workgroup projects. This is our contract work. Most of these I've talked about before, so in the interest of time, I'll kind of skim over them lightly. But there were some results. So very quickly on next slide, compressed printk, we actually got our final report that is online in the eLinux wiki. The summer results of that this was reported on at North LinuxCon and ELC Europe. Summary is that mainlining the existing system for compressing printks is quite difficult, but there were some really interesting techniques that were discovered for reducing printk message overhead. And so there's a set of recommendations in those results based on this work. Device tree documentation, this consists of better documentation for developers. The research work was done. There were talks given at LinksCon and ELC Europe, and we expect a written report soon. LTSI test framework. Test framework was reported on at LinksCon North America. And I don't know if the code can be downloaded. I think you can. I think that was the goal, but maybe Minakata-san or Shibata-san can comment on that, what the status is. Anyway, in terms of the others, I think we can skip over those. Let's. So the CE work group has some new projects that they're just starting, based on steering meetings that were held at LinuxCon Japan in May. So they're the Internet of Things, the standard embedded distribution, Linux and social infrastructure, and device mainlining. And we had work group sessions at ELC and at Plumbers for a lot of these. The goal was really to inform people about the new projects and solicit input and participation. So if you look at, we had my overcoming obstacles to mainlining, that's really, and the device mainlining BOTH. So the talk I just gave is really related to the mainlining project that we have. There was a Linux and infrastructure systems presentation, IoT BOF and a size BOF, and a standard embedded distribution BOF there. So we had a lot of work in Germany to expose these projects to people. The next steps are that we're going to probably have some meetings at either Collab Summit or ELC. ELC is coming up in March, and we're looking for companies who are interested in these projects. We have the LTSI project and the eLinux Wiki as other projects that the CE work group is working on. So the LTSI is now on the 3.14 kernel, and we're interested in companies using that and contributing to it. There are many presentations available on the status, so I'm not going to go into detail here, but particularly ELC 2014 and ELC Europe 2014, we had some presentations. The latest push in that project is for the testing facility, and that's the contract work that the CE work group is doing. Also, we've been discussing, we had a workshop meeting in Germany, and we talked about considering slower releases. So it seems like we might be going kind of too fast for the industry by doing one every single year. And also we talked about mechanisms to support additions to the project after the merge window. So next slide. And then the eLinux Wiki, great resource. You should use it. A lot of great information out there and stuff. You'll note from our contract work is being posted on there, and there's more material all the time. Okay, then finally, let's get to other stuff. We have just some ELCs, a couple of, talking about events, then ELC announcements, a little bit about distros. So, coming up events, we just finished Embedded Linux Conference Europe. A lot of slides are already online, I'm sure more will appear, and then videos for those should be made available in the next few weeks. And then Embedded Linux Conference is coming up, that will be in the U.S. in March, the 23rd through the 25th in San Jose. So already we're starting to work on those. Some interesting announcements. So Sony is now a premier member of the All Seen Alliance. And that is the alliance that is promoting all join and working on peer-to-peer ad hoc networking. There's also at ELC Europe was kind of the coming out party for the Purple Foundation, multi-company MIPS nonprofit. It's a little bit like Linaro, but for MIPS, focuses on, you know, supporting and advancing Linux on MIPS processors. It has a couple of projects, the Purple OpenWRT project and the MIPS QMU project. And then a very interesting announcement from the Linux Foundation. They have created a new organization called Drone Code, which is an open source UAV, unmanned aerial vehicle software group. And Andrew Tridgell, who's very famous for having done Samba support, is the lead engineer for that. And there was actually a talk on UAV stack at ELC Europe. So I think we're gonna see a lot more of that at Linux Foundation events, stuff about drones and quadcopters and unmanned vehicles using open source software. Let's see, distros. The big news for Android is stuff is moving from the staging directory. So Greg Crowe-Hartman, after all these years, has moved the binder code from staging to the Android directory in the kernel. And that was kind of big news. Lots of stuff has already been merged. I have a separate presentation that's out on the wiki that you can look at to show the Android mainline status. So Android has actually been making really good progress at getting mainline. It's down, I think they started with about 140,000 lines of code out of tree in the 3.0 release, and they're now down to under 30,000 lines of code that is out of tree. So developers, there's still a lot of work to do, but there's a lot of stuff that has gone into mainline from Android, which is really good. And then in terms of Tizen, they're doing a lot of security work with SMAC, and they have proposed it, proposed adding a meta layer for the Octo project. So they want to make that security work available even if you're not using Tizen itself. So that's pretty good. Okay, then resources. Where do I get my information from? LWN.net. You should subscribe to it. Kernel Newbies. Elinux.org. Make sure you check out the events page there to watch for the slides for events. And then the CE Linux Dev mailing list. And that's it. Sorry that was so fast. That was only 15 minutes. But I didn't want to go outside my time frame. So are there any questions?
Okay, I guess thank you in Harris. So thank you very much for your presentation and see you in December.
Yes, okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We'll see you then.
Okay, bye.